Steve Bowers and
Cassandra Fuller.
Welcome you to this virtual Still Six in the City.
Right.
Still might be back at the studio soon. We'll see.
Could be. Yep. It's looking like it. It's going to be exciting.
It'll be exciting. It'll be different to people. We'll see how it goes. I'd say that this has become normal, but right?
It has.
It has kind of become normal. Yeah.
Funny how going back to the studio will be just an adjustment.
So we will see. I trust it will make. We got a full show.
Yes, we do. We're going to be talking to the artist Mary Spellings. She's from Art in the Village because they have a pop-up shop coming up in this weekend, actually, as a matter of fact. Exactly, yeah. And then also we're going to talk to Mary a little bit about, or actually she's going to give us a tour of
Art in the Village.
Exactly. So if you've never seen it, you're going to get a special tour today. And then also Juanita Clay is here because there is a Bodacious conference coming up Saturday, June the 5th. We're going to find out a little bit more about that. And Juanita Jones is with us. She is our Hub City hero, and she's also with Keep My Hood Good. So we're going to talk to Miss Juanita. And then Randy Moffitt is here. He is with Relay for Life, because that is going to happen July the 23rd. So we're going to find out about the events and where it's going to be held. And then Diane Robinson with the NED is going to be here to talk about their season and the performing arts camps and a little bit about just everything that's going on with the NED. And then our music today is none other than Kelso Mojo. All so right. We've got a full show lined up for you today.
Right. Should and be those pretty art camps fun. Start next week, I think. So
yeah, they're pretty good. They're going to start pretty quickly. So
here we go. All right. Well, it's good to see you. And hang on, everyone. We're coming right back with this edition of Six in the City.
As the COVID-19 vaccines become available, you might be asking yourself, should I get it? And if I do, will I be able to go about life without putting my family at risk? You've got questions, and that's normal. The fact is, the vaccines are safe and effective. They're going to save lives. To get the latest on the COVID-19 vaccines, visit getvaccineanswers.org, because getting back to the moments we miss starts with getting informed. It's up to you.
As we all take care and precautions, practicing social distancing with more time at home, we may find ourselves using more broadband too, relying on internet, television, and telephone services to stay connected to work, school, and family. JA is working hard to keep our customers, employees, and families safe while bringing vital services during this time, keeping you connected to the essential broadband services Jackson's homes and businesses depend on is one thing you can count on at JA today.
When I first saw Turtle, my heart was full. Not anything but lonely.
We have this like deep connection, this heart connection.
He just wants to be close to you and part of your life.
Every day with Turtle is a perfect day.
When I'm holding her, it makes me feel calmer.
I think everything he does shows how much he loves us.
When we adopt a shelter pet, we discover they're a little bit of a lot of things.
But they're all pure love.
Steve Bowers and Cassandra Fuller welcoming you back to Six in the City. We're joined by Mary Spellings, artist in residence, artist and operator, and everything else at the Arts of the Village.
How are you doing, folks?
We're good.
How are yourself?
Mary's coming to us live today from Art in the Village, and we're going to take a look at that coming up in a few minutes right there in the Casey Jones Village, Jackson, Tennessee. We're here to preview a special event that is coming up in person this Saturday, the 22nd, and we're going to do Art in the Village. We're doing a pop-up shop. Is that what we're doing?
Exactly. We've got, we've done a lot of festivals out here in the past, Steve and Cassandra, but we're doing a new thing now. We're doing a little pop-up shop this Saturday only that will be to highlight our gallery artist. So we'll have lots of extra work out on the sidewalk here, and I'm sure people will be able to find some good deals on a lot of creative pieces that they might enjoy. We'll have pottery and we'll have paintings and maybe photography and jewelry, lots of fun stuff. Have some wood turnings. We have a new member in our gallery who turns wood. So those wood turn pieces are always a highlight.
Oh, nice. So what time is the event, Mary?
It'll be 9 to 5, our regular business hours.
Go ahead. We don't need tickets or anything for this, right? We just come on up.
No tickets. Just come and enjoy. You can you can have the opportunity to firsthand talk to the artist who made or created the pieces that will be here. And you know, I think that's always a really special thing. I know when people come in the gallery and look around at our work, they're always really interested to speak to the artist who created the work.
That's
what makes it special. The artist that did it is what makes it special. Because when you see a work of art, what you're buying is something that was that artist's idea, that where that artist sees that thing a certain way and nobody else sees it like that person does. So it kind of gives you a unique perspective on life.
It does. And it gives you the opportunity to just talk to the artist to say, okay, what were you thinking when you did this? You know, not that it was a bad thing or a good thing. It was just like, what was going through your mind? What instilled this thought in you to do this piece? So it's always interesting to hear the answers too, where the inspiration comes from.
Right. A lot of times it's, how did you do this thing?
Yeah.
I was working the other day and we had a fellow artist come in who lived in Texas. And we had a nice long conversation about how we did different types of art. And he told us about how he did different types of art. And, you know, it's important for artists to be able to support one another. That's one of our goals here at the gallery.
That's right. It is.
Mary, how many artists are working actively out of the gallery now?
I believe it's 27, Steve. Wow. It kind of comes and goes, one this away or one that away. But I believe it's 27 that we have right now. And we've got two new artists. We've got Greg Phillips, who turns wood. And then we've got Judy Emerson, who makes beaded jewelry. And both of them are just really special artisans. Their work is exceptional. You know, we kind of have the gamut of, we have some things in the gallery that are really what you'd consider fine art, and then we have some things that are more fine craft. So we've been here since 2009, and things keep evolving as far as the gallery goes, and the work that we have in the gallery changes all the time, as well as the artists. You know, we have several that have been here since the beginning. But then we pick up new artists once in a while, and a little new fresh blood is always a good thing.
So 12 years now.
Yeah.
12-year party. Wow.
Yep. Well, that's amazing, isn't it?
Yes, it is.
It is amazing.
The pop-up show is this coming Saturday. It's going to be the 22nd. It'll be from 9 till 5.
Uh-huh.
How many of the artists will be featured, Mary? Just kind of opening question right now.
I'm thinking probably 12 to 14.
So a good percentage.
With extra work, so, you know, maybe half.
Okay. Well, it'll be an opportunity to meet those artists and see their work and talk to them about their work. And that is no charge for this Saturday, 9 until 5. That's in the Casey Jones Village. Art in the Village in the Casey Jones Village. When we come back, we'll talk to Mary. Talk to her. She's going to take us on a tour, right?
Yeah, we're going to go for a tour and don't even have to leave our office.
Don't have to leave the office. So if you haven't been to Art in the Gallery, you're about to go.
That's exactly right.
You know, via Mary and her phone, right, and camera.
Yep.
On That's this. Right. Six in the
Six
city.
In the city.
The family's visit to the forest inspired a beautiful question. Mother, mother, am I a tree? You tell me to stand tall. You tell me to stay rooted. I think I am a tree. My child, of course you are. But what kind of tree will you be? The kind to hug or the kind to climb? Doesn't matter what you choose, so long as you choose to be a tree that's kind.
Make the forest part of your story at a park near you. Find one at discovertheforest.org.
Tired of internet that leaves you waiting and monitoring your usage with extra fees? Switch to E-Plus Broadband from the Jackson Energy Authority for fiber optic internet with the fastest speeds to keep everyone connected. Enjoy being online as much as you want without worrying about extra fees or data usage limits. Perfect for when you need to download and upload large files, stream videos, or use your favorite video conferencing app. E-Plus Broadband, fastest internet, no data caps, no slowdowns, no worries.
That's my neighbor, Joe. Hey, Joe.
Hey, John.
Joe's about to make a very big mistake. Hey, Joe, you think it might be a good idea to call 811 to have your underground utilities marked before you start digging?
John, that's just for big projects.
Actually, it's for any digging project. Congratulations, Joe, you found your electric line. Remember, safe digging always begins with a free call to 811. You want to borrow my phone, buddy?
six in the city, and we're going on a tour of art in the village with Mary Spelling. We're not going to see Mary, but we're going to see what's in the village, right? Or art in the village. The pop-up show is this coming Saturday, the 22nd, from 9 till 5, and you'll see the artwork of many of these artists on pop-up display out front. They will, some of them will be there. So you can talk to them about their art. So, Mary, where do we begin?
Take us on a tour.
I'm just going to do you a little walk through here. You can see that we have paintings. We have jewelry. We have woven pieces. A lot of really fine, beautiful work. These are made with sterling silver by our own Jenna Faye. We've got smaller items. We have necklaces and stuff made with ceramics, with clay. Then really bright colored little earrings and that kind of thing. Smaller art pieces. We just got lots of good stuff. Chokers made with glass drops. I don't know how they do that stuff, but they do. We've got a lot of stuff that is really good gift type items.
Okay.
This piece right here is by our own Elaine Vars. It's a woven piece, a woven canvas piece.
I was about to ask what that was. It's a unique piece.
Yes, it's very unique. Elaine does some really unique pieces. She does woven pieces as well with paper as well as canvas. We have cards personalized. Well, not personalized, with they're blank on the inside, but we have cards that have pictures of images of a lot of the artists in the gallery.
Wow.
So you can get them probably more economically than you can buying cards at Walmart. And when you do that, you are supporting local artists.
So we can not only come in and buy a gift, we can get the gift card to go with it and probably get it gift wrapped as well.
You can. You sure can.
One-stop shop. That's what I like.
In fact, some of the paintings that are in the gallery, we have a card that actually goes with them.
Okay.
Are you like yet, Cassandra?
Pardon me?
Are you seeing anything you like yet?
Of course. I always see something I like down there at the gallery when I go. Most of the time, I love all the paintings and I love the wood carvings and the jewelry and just the unique pieces. And I'm just so fascinated with the paintings and some of the detail in some of those paintings. It's just unreal how talented these artists are.
You know, if you add it up, I'm going to scoot back up here toward the front so you can see some of the wood carvings. So y'all forgive me for going in a blur. Maybe I started the wrong way. We've got just so many unique three-dimensional pieces, like the pottery that has the little birds on it, dishes of all types. We've got really unique wood pieces. You can see some of these.
Oh, wow. Yeah.
Are really cool. Piggy banks.
It's such a great place to go and get a gift for somebody if you're looking for that person that has everything. Because this is, you can just find something unique in here that you can bet that your person that you're buying for doesn't have. So
yeah, that's the truth.
No, and what an investment. So it's such a huge investment in the art, the artist, and the art community as well.
And we appreciate all the support. You know, we are a nonprofit corporation, so we really do appreciate the support of the community for our artists who are here. Without the community coming out and buying at Art in the Village, we wouldn't be able to stay in business. This is some of the new jewelry that we have, the beaded jewelry.
Oh, wow.
I'm doing it close enough that you can actually see.
Yeah.
In there. Sometimes you have reflections and stuff which mess you up.
Those pieces look nice. That looks like somebody has a lot of patience, which I don't.
He's even made a bracelet, an Elvis bracelet out of beads.
Wow.
Wow. Yeah.
How cool is that? That would be perfect for the biggest Elvis fan.
Yes, it would. Just lots of really unique pieces. I'm gonna go back up to this is a piece by Sandy Heisman, which is a glass piece. It's like a vase.
Yeah.
But it's just really unique. It's got legs.
Oh, wow.
Well, Mary, we appreciate the tour. They're telling us we've got to get away. So we want you to know how much we appreciate this.
Yes, thanks for the tour, Mary. This was
fascinating. This is Art in the Village. It's in the Casey Jones Village. And this Saturday, 9 till 5, there's the pop-up shop out front. Many of these artists will be there, but you can tell just with this sampling, there's a lot to see.
That's right.
You got a gift to give or art to buy.
Art to buy.
That's the place here in Jackson. Well, we're going to take a break from Art in the Village, and we're going to the main stage, as we say, and we welcome Kelso Mojo.
Thank you.
The SOAR Award, System Operational Achievement Recognition, presented by the American Public Gas Association, recognizes forward-thinking natural gas utilities that continually improve operation capabilities, adapt to challenges, and the changing demands of safe, reliable natural gas distribution. In 2019, the APGA Gold SOAR Award was presented to the Natural Gas Division of JEA. System integrity, forward-thinking innovation, all a real part of JEA today.
At Southern Family Dentistry, we offer dental treatment for your entire family. We have the latest 3D digital x-ray system. We offer implants, veneers, teeth whitening, and all the other normal services you receive at the dental office. We have two offices, one in Milan and one in Jackson, and E-Plus broadband telephone services allows us to connect both of those offices. It doesn't matter which office the patient calls, we have the ability to speak to that patient at either location.
I don't remember how it started.
Go to that.
Oh boy.
our back and forth, it always came back.
Dad!
You probably don't remember what you told me.
That was perfect.
But I heard every word.
Welcome back to Six in the City. Steve Bowers, Cassandra Fuller with you. We are joined by Juanita Clay, and we're going to be talking about the Bodacious Conference that's coming up. Juanita, good to have you with us.
Yes, good to have you.
Well, thank you for having me today.
Appreciate you very much. Appreciate you being with us. A Bodacious Conference is what?
That name kind of throws everyone off, but that was a God-given name because it meant relentless in pursuit, you know, not easily to surrender. And so we're doing a Bodacious Women Conference, and it's 23 years old. We've been to Florida, Georgia, Mississippi, now we're in Tennessee.
Okay. Oh, wow.
So this is going to be, it's going to be Saturday, June 5th. Is this going to be a virtual conference, in-person conference? What's this going to be?
Yes, it's going to be a virtual conference as well. We're doing three venues to reach everyone. We're doing the virtual Zoom at the conference center. We're going to do a call-in session, and we're also going to do, you know, the Zoom.
Okay.
All right. So where is the in-person conference going to be held at, Ms. Bonnie?
It's going to be at the Clarington Convention Center on 541 Carriage Drive, Carriage House Drive in Jackson.
Okay.
So what should we expect when we, if we're actually coming to the event, what would we expect to see or hear?
All right, come comfortable.
I like that.
Yes, no dress. This is not a dress and dress conference. This is a conference of comfort. You come, we have two speakers, Apostle Yolanda Adams of Humboldt, Tennessee, Prophetess Faith Collier of Selmer, Tennessee, and yours truly, Juanita, will be there, and we'll have some surprises in the middle with some ladies describing the theme. It's our time, because we've been locked up for a while now, so it's our time to get out and shine and rediscover who we are, because we've been through a lot in these last year and a half, and so that's the name of the conference, the theme, rather. It's our time. And so when they come, we have dope prizes. We're just going to do one-day conference this time, and we'll probably end the middle of about 2:30, from 9:30 to 2:30.
Okay. Do we need tickets to attend the convention?
Yes, I am so sorry. Yes, we're asking for a donation of $20 for the conference. It's $20 if you do the conference call online, individually at your homes. It's also $20 if you come in person at the conference center. And we have this year churches in Florida that wants to Zoom in as a group. And so they're pledging $200 towards a conference to help cover the expenses. So I'm excited. We got three or four churches lined up in Florida. And so maybe we can get a couple more. We're hoping in Georgia. And so it's going to be a great thing.
Miss Juanita, who is your intended audience? Who do you want to attend these via either Zoom or the actual event, or who are you trying to talk to?
My target group is any woman that has been through some trials and tribulation and need an answer, need someone to talk to, somebody to have patience to teach them that they're more than enough. We're asking them to come. Our age group is like 18 and above. And if they're
anybody that's experienced trials and tribulations, Miss Juanita, that's a large group of us, because, you know,
we all need to be there, because it's our time.
Yes, it is. Yes. It's our time. We got to get out and shine, don't we?
Well, I hate to break up this women's party here, but I wanted to ask a question. Juanita, how do people, if they want to Zoom in or whatever, how can they link with you, or how do they get that information?
All right, we'll be posting the link the day of the conference, rather than night before the conference. And as the ladies send their pledge in, we'll send it to them so they have it on time. And for the churches, the same thing. And for the individuals coming to the conference center, they can pay when they get there. Okay. They can give the donation when they get there.
So Juanita, what is that contact information? If they want to contact you or send it in, they send that.
Okay. Right. We got a contact information. Juanita Clay. You can send it to my email, JuanitaClay98@gmail.com.
Right.
You can call me individually, 731-608-8483. Have my daughters. If you just need the registration form, just email me and I'll get that to you.
All right.
Well, and that was Juanita Clay 98. Is that right? JuanitaClay98@gmail.com.
Yeah.
Okay. And 608-8483-731 area code.
Correct.
Juanita, so good to see you. Glad
yes,
you're,
thank you so
glad
much.
You're putting this on in Jackson, Tennessee. We look forward to hearing more about it. Thank you a lot.
Thank
We're going
you
back to the lot. Main stage. And once again, we welcome the very talented Kelso Mojo.
Take this song and you'll never feel left all alone. Take me to your heart, fill me in your bones. Just one more night and I'm coming off this lone and winding road.
We are in an opioid crisis. More and more of our neighbors are dying from opioid overdoses. More than 1,300 Tennesseans in 2018 alone. You have the power to reverse this deadly trend. Because of the COVID-19 outbreak, Jackson-Madison Prevention Coalition is now offering free Narcan training online and by phone. Narcan reversal kits are available. Contact Mark Mason at 731-694-0741. That's 731-694-0741. Don't let your loved one become a statistic.
For the most reliable drinking water supply at the highest quality, reach for the tap. Our tap water is safe and continues to exceed all government requirements. For more information about our drinking water, visit www.jacksenergy.com/JEACCR.
Move over. It's the law. When approaching work vehicles or crews, move over to create a safety zone. It protects utility workers, law enforcement, firefighters, and emergency personnel. It's not an option. Slow down. It could save a life. Stay safe. Move over.
Hi, I'm Kedrick Perkins, PGA General Manager at Jackson Country Club. Jackson Country Club's amenities are true Southern hospitality. Championship golf course, fine dining, 6 tennis courts, Junior Olympic pool and fitness. We pride ourselves in giving our members the best. Choosing JEA was a logical choice so that we could tie in our phone, internet, and cable solutions so that we can advance our next segment of technology.
Juanita Jones has been a guest of ours for the last several years. She's done some extraordinary work in this community with Keep My Hood Good and other things that she has initiated. She was just recently honored by the mayor of this city and the city council and all the city of Jackson as a Hub City Hero, the one for the month of May. And so, Juanita, it's good to see you, and congratulations.
Yes, congratulations.
Hi, y'all. Thank y'all for the moment.
Yeah. How did you find out that you were a Hub City Hero?
Well, I was, of course, in the garden. I was all dirtied up, and my phone rang, and it said mayor's office. I thought, oh, my gosh, the mayor is calling me. And I said hello, and it was Amy. Amy says, Juanita, you will be the recipient of the May Heroes, Hub City Heroes, and I just shouted. I just screamed, and I was delighted. Stunned and proud.
Well, it's quite an honor.
Yes. Last time I got a call from the mayor, Juanita, it was over something about unpaid parking ticket. I was just kidding, but you know, got a call that I get. Juanita, the Keep My Hood Good program is where now? We've had this huge disruption with COVID and everything else. You were a winner of the 100 Women of Tennessee, West Tennessee, right?
Yes, 100
Women Who Care. Women Who Care, and Cassandra Fuller was part of all that, and what a special recognition and presentation. But where are we with the program? What's been happening this last year?
Yeah, well, over just last year, for the year of 2020, of course, we closed down of March because of the COVID, but we had been planning all 2020. And so just recently, May 8th, we had our first mural on Whitehall unveiling. Okay. And it's abstract painting representing unity, community, accountability, and love. And we also have just recently planted our first crop of the year at our community garden. We planted corn, okra, sweet peppers, some bell peppers, jalapeno peppers. I know it. Yeah. And our
throw
summer
some tomatoes.
We did not do tomatoes this year. We did tomatoes the last 2 years, but we did not do it this time. But we've got 3 more planting seasons this year. So that's very exciting.
Is your garden close to your building?
Yes, not very far. Actually, our center is at 119 Riverside Drive, right off of Airways.
Yep.
And our garden is at the corner of East Chester and Hayes. So not very far.
No, not far at all.
Yeah, yeah. We also have our summer program. We'll begin. We're going to reopen June 7. We're going to do a 6-week program through July 15. Our focus would be self-identity and connecting to nature.
Okay.
Yeah.
How do you get registered for this program?
Well, actually, I find the children.
Oh, is that right? Okay.
Yeah. I just go out.
Just kind of the way this has always worked.
That's right. Yes, sir. I just go out in the neighborhood and I just do a little research and study the children. And I say, okay, I want him or I want her. Yeah. So that's how it's been.
Wow. Well, Nita, you've done amazing work down through these years with these children, and you just planted yourself in the neighborhood and went out and found them.
Yes, sir. It's been great. It's been really great. Actually, this year has been 12 years that I have found Keep My Hood Good. Yep. We will be having in October our annual fundraiser, so I will ask later on to if I could come on and make that announcement.
But, are you on Facebook with Keep My Hood Good?
Yes. We have a Facebook page, Keep My Hood Good, and we have our website, www.keepmyhoodgood.org. It also has volunteers can sign up on the garden or volunteer for the children.
Okay.
And you can reach me at 731-293-3800.
Okay. Oh, wow. Juanita, so good to see you. Congratulations. Yes. She is the Hub City Hero for the month of May. So City of Jackson, Juanita Jones, and Keep My Hood Good. We're going to find out about Relay for Life. We'll do that next as we continue. Six in the City.
Here at the Emergency Operations Center, we rely on E-Plus Broadband Fiber Network to better serve Madison County. With high-speed internet, we track storms and natural disasters in real time. Also, fiber internet gives us the speed to host training classes preparing responders from all over the county and state. The phone system allows us flexibility to stay in contact and make conference calls with both in and out of the office with local, state, and federal agencies. Connectivity is an important part of emergency management.
Want to receive account information via text? When you enroll in JA Alerts, you can. Text to get a bill balance, due date, set a payment extension, receive an outage notification. Reply to report an electric outage. Text JOIN, J-O-I-N, text JOIN to 53248, 53248. Cell phone number must be current and attached to your JA account. Visit jacksenergy.com/textalert for more information.
With E-Plus Broadband and Watch TV Everywhere, you can now take your TV on the go. Just visit WatchTVEverywhere.com to sign up. Then you're all set to catch your favorite shows, movies, and sports wherever and whenever you want on any internet-connected device. Choose from our growing selection of networks from your cable package at no extra charge. Visit WatchTVEverywhere.com to learn more. It's easy to sign up for E-Plus Broadband's TV Everywhere.
Well, COVID disrupted many things over the last year, and one of those was Relay for Life. But Randy Moffitt is with us. Good to see you, Randy. And he's here to say that Relay for Life is coming back.
It's coming back July 23rd, Farmers Market. Always a fantastic venue. It's going to coincide with the Killer Bees at the Amp that night. So,
Okay.
So we're coming back strong, coming back heavy.
You'll camp out right beside a big act and a big event. And there you go. Well, that's excellent. Yeah. So what do we need to be doing then to get ready for this, Rain?
Well, you can register your team at life.org/MadisonTN. And you can buy luminaries there as well. You can reach out to Amy Morris, myself, for more information. But it's just a fantastic event. And the whole purpose for Relay is to celebrate those that have survived, honor those that have fought and we've lost, and also to give a little TLC to the caregivers. People kind of forget about those folks that have been alongside, family and friends that have fought alongside those folks. So we want to raise as much money as we can, bring a lot of awareness to Relay for Life, and we want to put an end to cancer.
What will be the setup that night, Randy? Sometimes the teams have displays and stuff, so what's going to be the format for the?
Yeah, Steve, it's the best food in West Tennessee. I'm not kidding you. We've got folks that are doing barbecue and fried Oreos and just everything in between. So there'll be vendors selling other items as well. So it's a family-friendly event, great music, great atmosphere, and a better cause.
Okay. And that's coming up. It's going to be July 23rd. I take that's a Saturday night. Is that right? Or Friday night? Saturday night.
Friday.
All right, Friday, July 23rd.
And starts at what time, Randy?
I believe 5.
Okay. 5 o'clock.
Yeah. If you get there early, just hang around for a little bit. It'd be okay. But yeah, I think 5. Yeah,
go ahead and grab something to eat while you're there. All right, so once again, the way to put together a team then and what you do is you go to what address is this now?
Life.org.
Or, okay.
/MadisonTN.
All right, /MadisonTN. What are you looking for teams to do? At one time they did their own booths, sold like things and all that stuff, raised money. So what's going to be the theme or the work this year?
Yeah, it'd be the same. They'll sell food. The vendors will sell their products, homemade items, things like that. Just anything that they can do to help contribute to Relay, to help put an end to cancer. And again, it's all about raising awareness and raising funds.
Randy, part of this has been the Survivor's Walk and all that. Will there be a format for that?
I'm not for sure. We're going to scale it back a little bit because of COVID. We're wanting to abide by some restrictions. So it'll be a scaled back a little bit type event, but it's still going to be as big as we can make it. We just want to be cautious and careful. And while I'm on that, everybody, please make sure you're getting your screenings as well. COVID really did a number on those that had to fight cancer. So please, everybody, make sure you're getting screened.
You know, we just lost more people than we want to think about, Randy.
I know.
Kind of tough here. Right. Your head. Well, Relay for Life is coming back. It'll be Friday, July 23rd, starting around 5 o'clock. And so put a team together, go to life.org and /MadisonTN, right? Are you on Facebook, Randy, with this or?
Yes. I think Amy's, I don't know the name of the Facebook page, but I know Amy's got one.
Okay. So just be looking for that. And we'll be heading into that on July 23rd. Who all's working with you? Are there sponsors we need to recognize, Randy, for the event this year?
There are. I don't have that list in front of me.
Okay.
But yes, there are.
All right. So we want to thank everybody that's involved with this and look forward to glad to have Relay for Life back. And then the amp is going to have the King Bees that night.
Killer Bees.
Yes.
Yeah. And so it'll be a special night. That'll be Friday, July 23rd. And that'll be at the Farmer's Market and the amp and everything else here in Jackson. Randy, good to see you. Glad it's coming back. Life.org/MadisonTN to put your team together and get things started.
That's right.
The American Cancer Society. All right. Great. Good to see you, Randy. Glad you're all working us back in the schedule.
Appreciate it.
We are going to go back to the main stage. We welcome once again the very talented Kelso Mojo.
Mojo. Oh, yeah. say it, and see it with voice control. Find your favorites faster across live, recorded, and streaming TV. Movies, shows, news, sports, music are just a voice command away. Show me action movies. Just for kids. Every result personalized based on viewing habits and time of day. Say it, watch it. It's that easy with the power of voice control.
Need to check your bill balance? Set a payment extension. Get outage notifications. With JEA, it's easy. Text. When you enroll in JEA Alerts, you open all those possibilities. To enroll, text JOIN, J-O-I-N, to 53248. Text JOIN to 53248. If your cell phone number is current, two-way texting is yours. Real-time communication, direct customer service with JEA today.
I'm Mark Taylor. I'm the owner of Renew Biomedical Services based out of here in Jackson, Tennessee. We're a provider of biomedical services for medical professionals. At Renew Biomedical, our use of telecom is of utmost importance. We have to reach our customers in a timely fashion so we can diagnose and service their equipment needs. So E-Plus Broadband allows Renew Biomedical to connect effectively with our customers in whichever way they choose, via email, phone, Skype, teleconferencing, in any way you can imagine.
Welcome back to Six in the City. Steve Bowers and Cassandra Fuller with you. And we welcome one of our favorite folks, Diane Robinson, who's been working with us for several years here. Kind of like old home week this week, bringing people back in that have been away for a while because of COVID and everything else.
That's right.
Diane is with the Ned, and we want to talk about the upcoming season, and that has been announced, and those season tickets are available. But first, we have some performing arts camps, and the reason we mentioned that is the one for 8 and 9-year-olds starts Monday the 24th, so it's right here.
It is right here. Okay. We're excited.
So what do we need to know about this, Diane, and how do we register our youngsters if we want them to participate?
Okay, we actually only have one spot left in that camp. Now, there are a few spots left in the June camp.
Okay.
But one spot left in Performing Arts Camp 2, and it's 9 to 2 every day, and it's $85 for that camp. And we actually put on the performance of Pinocchio at the end of the week.
Okay. Okay. So that's for 8 and 9-year-olds. And so there's one spot left. You can call 425-8397. 425-8397. And then the one for 10 to 13-year-olds will start June 1st. It goes through the 11th. So it's a bit longer as far as time period.
It's a bit
what
longer
happens in that one?
Right. That one is 9 to 2 as well. It's 150 for that camp. We have a few spots left for that one. And in that camp, we're going to be doing The Adventures of Robin Hood. So we're excited about that too.
All right. Since we're talking theater, you've got a production of Oklahoma that's coming up.
Ooh,
already yes, underway. Your cast has been selected. Fuller's got a relative that's a cast member in there.
I do. I sure do.
Yes, she does, Miss Briley. And I've got a cast member in there, a few. And yes, we're really excited about Oklahoma. And those dates are the 24th, 5th, and 6th of June. Okay. And
can we get tickets now?
Is it what?
Can we get tickets?
You can get tickets at 425-8397. They're 10 and 12 adult and children prices. And then there was something I was going to tell you. Oh, we have about 40 plus people in the cast.
Wow. Okay.
Yeah. That's a big cast.
Working already.
That is a big cast.
So they're working. They started working even when they were still in school.
They did. It takes us about 2 months, a little over, to do a musical that big. So we've been working on that one for just a minute.
So that is coming up then in June 24th, 25th, and 26th. And that'll be at 425-8397 if you want to go ahead and get tickets. Those performances, will they be evening or in the day or a mixture?
Okay, the 24th and 5th will be at 7 p.m. and June 26th will be at 2.
Okay.
That's on a Saturday.
We'll pick up a Saturday matinee there. Well, in the midst of all this, if Diane didn't have enough to do, we've got the Ned season put together. And we're going to start with Sean Johnson on September the 17th. That's the big band experience. We got the Irish Christmas that's coming back in December. No Time Flat, which is bluegrass. They'll be there February the 11th. Caleb Minter will do R&B then, and that's on March the 25th, I think. And then Kelly Cash will round out the season in April with her traditional Cash Country concert. So a big, big season. So how do we go about getting tickets for this?
Now, right now, the tickets that are on sale are our season tickets, and they can call that same number, 425-8397, or they can go online and do it themselves if they want to. The only thing they need to know about these tickets this year is that there is tax being added to them. So those prices, they're either $25 or $30 for each show plus tax. Okay. And then fees if you charge on your credit card. So, But we're looking forward to that. It's going to be a great season, and we're working really hard. The individual sale tickets will go on sale June the 1st. So if they don't want to buy the season ticket and they just want to buy one or two shows, they can do that after June 1st.
Where is this schedule posted where people can see it?
It's on the Ned's Facebook page, and it should be on the city website as well.
City website as well. Okay.
Yeah, I need to double check that, but I know that it's on the Ned's Facebook page. So, okay.
Well, in the midst of all this, we get word that you're planning to retire.
After 28 years, I have decided to go play with grandchildren. And learn to sew maybe a little bit and go travel a tiny bit.
Just a little bit of whatever you want to do, right?
A little bit of whatever. That's exactly right.
Well, it's always a pleasure working with you, and we wish you the best. Hope we'll see you again soon. And don't forget, summer camps, 425-8397. Got one spot for May 24th and a few spots for the older ones starting in June. We'll see you soon, Diane. Continued best.
Congratulations. Thanks so much for having me back.
Thank you very, very much.
Bye-bye.
We're going to be right back with more Six in the City.
When I heard the word leukemia, I was terrified.
Thanks. Right here in West Tennessee, people are fighting for their lives.
Even though you know they're taking chemotherapy and they got a long road ahead, if they can maintain their smile and their energy, it makes it a whole lot easier.
That's why platelets are so vital. Wendy's blessed. Her son survived.
There's only one place to get platelets, and that's from people like you. Please give.
Doing what's never been done. The American Public Power Association includes over 2,000 local public utility systems. Over 15 years, the APPA has presented RP3 awards, recognizing system reliability, safety, workforce development, and improvement. JA in 2020 not only received the top-level Diamond RP3 award, it was presented to JA for the 7th time. No utility has been so recognized. Honored Public Power, another part of JA Today.
When I was your age, I was just like you, fascinated by stars. But now I get to search for life in the universe. And who knows, maybe life is looking for us too.
So we're like aliens to them?
Yeah. Does anyone want to be a scientist now?
I do.
Awesome, we need more girls in STEM.
Maybe we can find aliens.
Welcome back. Welcome back to 60. I think that's a cue. You're up right there.
That was the fastest cue ever.
Fastest cue known to man.
That's right.
Well, we were just reminded that the Miss Tennessee Volunteer Pageant is coming back to the city June 16th through the 19th. It's just right around the corner.
Just a month away. A month.
Well, less than a month away.
Less than a month away.
Well, I guess it is a month away as we're doing this.
I know. Right. It's crazy. Wow. I can't believe
it. Man, oh, man. Hard to believe. And so that'll be carried live at E+ TV6. Looking forward to that. And, of course, coming up next weekend, it's Memorial Day, May 31st. And the weekend, Memorial Weekend going in. Steve Beverly will do the TV Classic Marathon, and he will start on Friday the 28th, and that will go through. Speaking of all that, of course, the 27th, 28th, and 29th, the Ohio Valley Conference is bringing their best baseball championship tournament to this city. Glad to see them back.
Right.
They will advance then into the NCAA regionals and all, and hopefully have a team representing them in the World Series. But it's top flight collegiate baseball is coming in. We got a team from Canada, the Winnipeg Goldeyes, that are going to do a homestand against the Chicago Dogs this coming weekend, Friday, Saturday, and Sunday, 6:35 Friday and Saturday and Sunday at 105. They're doing fireworks show after the baseball Saturday night and all that stuff. And so we got a collision on the way between a team that's staying here, the Jackson Generals, and a mayor that says y'all got to leave after the Mercy Me concert on the 3rd. We'll see how that worked out. But they announced that Old Dominion is coming to the park July the 17th. So you know, we can't predict. We'll just let you know. And that's so right. We'll see. But that's a big country act coming here.
Now you know what we know.
Yeah, you know what we know. And they will distribute American flags if you want to decorate a cemetery at Ridgecrest this coming Saturday morning at 9. They'll ask you for volunteers to help decorate. And then they will make those available. If you've got a cemetery you'd like to decorate, you can pick up the flags there from VFW 6496 and the West Tennessee Veterans Coalition. Fuller, so good to see you.
It is good to see you.
You know, and just stunned that nobody's running this weekend, but I'm glad you got a weekend off.
Well, you know.
Yeah, we're going to close. We thank them for being with us. We're going to close out with a very talented Kelso Mojo. Good Lord willing, we'll see you next week for more Six in the City.
In my life.